I recently recorded a couple of videos on the subject of our Creator's calendar and when the Sabbaths are in relationship to His calendar. In those segments, I brought up Isaiah 14, where he prophesied that Satan would exalt himself above the mountains of the appointed times. I have also discussed in Daniel 7, where Daniel prophesied that Satan would empower the beast to change the laws and times. I discussed how Satan could not change the appointed times because they are written in the word of Elohim, which endures forever. Therefore, it would be impossible for him to set on the mountain of the Most High's appointed times, unless, of course, he could change the calendar system that the Creator put in place for us to keep track of his appointed times, his Sabbaths, and his feast. Satan is a liar, and he perverts the truth. If we follow his system, we give our allegiance to him, and this is what has happened. As prophesied, he has successfully changed the calendar that was given to us to keep track of our Creator's appointments. Today, I want to discuss the changing of time a little further and discuss what the opponents to this truth say. First, let's examine the school of thought that is most prevalent in the world today, and that is that the seven-day cycle has been continuous and non-interrupted. The seventh day of creation was the Sabbath, as we know. If we count from there, we can see a problem in the second month with the way that man calculates time today. After the first 30 days, the seventh day would be on the fifth day of the month. And 30 days later, basing on a 30-day month, as all months originally were, it would be on the third day. And then the next month, the seventh day would be on the first day, and so on. Following that process through, the Sabbath will eventually land on every day of the month on this type of computing system, as we have today. With this system, the seventh day of the week could be on the sixth day of the month. Is this how our Creator designed it? Sounds kind of confusing. They did not have days named as we do today. They had days numbered through the month, 1 through 29 or 30, and the days of the week were 1 through 7. Their life revolved around the 7-day count, as ours should as well. So having the 7th day potentially land on all 30 days of the month certainly would have been a mess to keep track of. In Genesis 1, we read, "He put the sun and the moon in place as lights so that we can keep track of His appointed times." In Psalms 104, we read that he said he placed the moon here for us to be able to determine his appointed times. Let's simply be honest with ourselves and believe the word. And let's not lose sight as well of the fact that Scripture says that Satan will deceive everyone. And it says that he will purpose to change the appointed times and set on the mountain of them. Scripture tells us that every month begins with a new moon. This is an undeniable fact. In this segment, I will not get into whether this is the first visible crescent or the conjunction phase. For now, I will leave that on the simple fact that history has well documented that when our Messiah was here, the Jewish people were using the visible crescent, and he certainly observed the same. I will do as he did. The opponents to the Sabbath being lunar-based bring up a few points. One, they say that the moon was not placed here until the fourth day. I don't know what their point is. Well, with that logic, the first month didn't begin on day one either. So I do not claim to have all the answers by any means, but I just choose to believe the word. Did he put the moon here on the fourth day in its fourth day phase of its cycle? I do not know, but that certainly would fit. I want to break this thought here and mention something that some listening to this might not know, and that the days of the month now, according to the lunar cycle, are on average 29.53 days. I do not believe that this was always the case. Scripture uses a 30-day month for prophecies and such. So when did it change? There are two basic ideas. One would be when the flood happened, that maybe our Creator changed the rotations to allow for rain, since prior to that time all was watered from the ground up. The other explanation could be when Hezekiah was going to die, he cried out to Yahweh, and Yahweh added 15 years to his life. Hezekiah asked Isaiah for a sign that he would be healed, as he said he would be, and Isaiah told him that Yahweh would either move the sun back 10 degrees or forward 10 degrees on the sundial. It was his choice. Hezekiah chose boldly. His reasoning is not such a big thing that it go forward 10 degrees, because it does that anyway throughout the course of the day. But let him back it up to prove to me. And Yahweh made it happen. Did he change the rotation of the plane of the sun in order to make this happen, therefore changing the lunar cycle as well? I believe he did, and as a sign for all of us to follow that he is all-powerful and he wants to heal us if we would cry out to him in obedience, not just spiritually, but physically as well. But that's another subject matter. In any case, the days of the month were shortened. Now we have either 29 days or 30 days in a month based on the new moons. Back to the subject. What are the proofs in Scripture that the Sabbath is based on the new moon? I will list several. First, no one that I've ever heard of denies that the first day of each month was determined by the new moons, and they still are today by those who call themselves the Jewish people. Well, kind of, sort of, anyway. They've perverted this as well, but that's another subject as well. These beginning of the months determine when the feast and the high days are. No one disputes this, and no one disputes that these are appointed times. Scripture plainly validates that the weekly Sabbaths are appointed times as well. In the same scriptures of Leviticus 23 that establish that the feast and the high days are appointed times. So the new moons are to determine some appointed times, but not others. Does our Creator have two calendar systems? No. He set up the same calendar system for us to keep track of days and years as well as his appointed times, and the weekly Sabbaths are his appointed times. Another proof, every time in Scripture that the weekly Sabbath is referred to in relation to a specific date on the monthly calendar, it is always one of these four dates. Another proof, the children of Israel would have to have marched around Jericho on the Sabbath day if the seven-day cycle was continuous, because they marched seven straight days. Did Yahweh command his children to break his laws by marching on the Sabbath? No, they started the march on the first day of the month, just the new moon day, just as recorded in the book of Jasher. It is the only possible scenario. Another proof, if the cycle was indeed continuous, then some years the Israelites would need to purchase a lamb for the Passover on the Sabbath. If they did not have one, and if they did have one, they would have to go out and catch it and bring it into their gates on the Sabbath. This is because they are commanded to do this on the 10th day of the first month. And sometimes the 10th day would land on a Sabbath in the current perverted system that's in place today. An interesting point here that I'll make also, the most commonly believed theory out there today by Saturday Sabbath keepers is about the 3 days that Yeshua was in the tomb, which were the 15th, the 16th, and the 17th. They are correct about the number of the dates within the month. This is obvious. But they think that the 15th day is the fifth day of the week, the 16th day is the sixth day of the week, and the 17th day is the seventh day of the week. There is a problem with this if they would just think about it. That would have made the previous week's Sabbath on the 10th day of the month. This is the day that Yeshua was cheered into Jerusalem by the crowds, just as the Passover lamb was separated 4 days before it was sacrificed. They were cutting down branches and such in his path. If this was a weekly Sabbath, then Yeshua broke his father's law by making the ass carry him as carrying a burden on the Sabbath. Also, were the Jewish people the day buying and selling in the temple on the Sabbath? Because he drove them out for doing such, for buying and selling in the temple. Do you really think the Sadducees and the Pharisees of that day were buying and selling in the temple on a Sabbath day or allowing for it? Granted, it's hard to believe that they would have been allowing for it on any day, but their greed played a role in that. However, I can assure you that they were not buying and selling in the temple on the Sabbath day, or buying and selling anything on the Sabbath day. Yet, this is a commonly held belief by nearly every Saturday Sabbath keeper. The translation errors in the New Testament saying that it was the first day of the week that Mary came to the tomb is what makes this belief seem to have credibility. But once again, all we need to do is believe the Scriptures. And the Scripture tells us plainly that Yeshua kept his father's law and was without sin. Plus, Yeshua repeatedly said himself that he would be resurrected on the third day. And it was on the third day. He died on the 14th day in the afternoon, just as the Passover lambs are killed. His burial was complete before the morning of the 15th of the month, which is the seventh day of the week, every month in my father's calendar. The day begins at dawn, just as Scripture teaches, not at sundown the night before, as those following today's perverted Jewish calendar teach and observe. He was in the tomb for 3 24-hour periods, just as he said. The first day of the week is the 16th of the month, as it always is on the true calendar, and the second day of the week is the 17th of the month, as it always is. As day number 3 of his burial came to an end, as it began to dawn the third day, he was resurrected, just as he said. It is totally a matter of knowing how time is kept and believing true Scripture. I won't get into the mistranslations for now because of time on those verses, but maybe I'll do a segment on those. The translators had to twist to prove their false beliefs, so we must be diligent and sort through the lies. With the truth, everything fits perfectly into place. Scripture says plainly that the Sabbath, referring to the 15th, was a Sabbath, a weekly Sabbath, and a high Sabbath. It was the weekly Sabbath and the first day of unleavened bread, just as it is every year on the 15th day of the first month. The 10th day of the first month is when the Passover lambs are set apart, just as Yeshua was set apart as he was heralded into Jerusalem as a king. And it is always on the second day of the 7-day week. No exceptions. Are you seeing how easy so many things could be perverted by Satan if he could just pull off making a counterfeit calendar system? Consider another thing. The Julian calendar that was in place that many used at that time did not even have Saturn's day, which later became Saturday, as being on the seventh day of the week. For that matter, from what I have gathered, the Romans were enforcing an 8-day week at that time. And in any case, from what I've read, Saturday was the first day of the week back then. But all this doesn't really matter as well, as long as we just stay focused on the truth and believe in the truth, and all else will fall into place. Without the truth, we have confusion. Does our Creator want to make it confusing? No. His calendar system is simple for all to understand. But first, we have to let go of the lies and let go of the false calendar system. The second primary topic that the opponents to my father's calendar system bring up is, they will say, what about the manna? While Israel was in the desert, 6 days the manna fell, and on the sixth day there fell enough for 2 days. What did they eat on the 30th day or the new moon day? Like I said, I don't have all the answers. I suppose the manna would have fallen on the 30th day as well, and I suspect on the new moon day as well. If not, they certainly had their livestock to eat, and the new moon day was a festival day with extra sacrifices being made. These opponents asked then, why was it not recorded? As of all things, my father has everything under his control. His plan is perfect. I know that it has not been his intention to save all mankind of these first 6,000 years, but rather to call and to prepare the first fruits of his family. These are those who grew in his truth to a point where they chose to believe him and to be protected from the deceiver. They choose to get their instructions from him through his spirit. If he did not want Moses to record what happened with the manna on these days, that is his choice. He is all-knowing. I also know that he wants those who will fight their way through the muck and the mire and listen to him and believe his words and seek his wisdom and understanding. The walk that these first fruits have been tried through has not been a cakewalk for them. It was not handed to them on a silver platter. They had to search out the truth and from its only source, and they had to live it. The opponents then might try to say, well, then the first week of each month was more than 6 days of work. No, it wasn't. The new moon day is not a Sabbath, but neither is it a work day. It is a day of celebration and a worship day. There is no buying or selling allowed on this day. Nothing has changed for 6 millennia. The man scoffs at the truth, but that day is fast approaching an end. Like I said before, all things are simply a matter of believing him and acting on that belief. Here is a review. Did he not say that he gave us the moon to determine his appointed times? Yes, he did. There are the examples of the Sabbath falling on these dates in the scriptures, and there are not any examples of the Sabbath falling on any different dates. Also, there are historical records that show that the Jewish people were basing the Sabbaths based on the new moons at the time that Yeshua was here, and he was observing the Sabbath with them, and he did not sin, as we know. This one fact alone should be enough for anybody to choose to live the lunar-based Sabbath day. The Jewish historical records even admit this. The secular sources out there prove it as well if you search. And again, did our Creator command Israel to march around Jericho on the Sabbath day? No. And did he command the children of Israel to set apart or purchase the Passover lamb on a day that could sometimes be the Sabbath day? No. And remember, if Saturday is the Sabbath and Yeshua was resurrected that day as the Saturday Sabbath keepers uphold, then the week before when he came into Jerusalem was also a Sabbath. Did he really cause that they asked to work on that day? And were the Jewish people really buying and selling in the temple on the Sabbath day? Does our Creator really have two calendar systems, one where the months are counted and another where the days are counted that don't line up with one another? Does he make it that confusing? No, Satan has changed the laws and how the times are calculated indeed. He has influenced man to make and enforce these changes because man has chosen to live without his Creator's protection.